Hi, welcome back. Continuing my series on Tenneco versus Dyson, I'll be comparing the PureOne S12 and the Dyson V10 Absolute. The V10 is a step down from the V11, but it's a less expensive alternative that is a better option on hard surfaces as it comes with a fluffy attachment. So I'll be going through the similarities and differences between these premium stick vacuum options and the results of the tests. Hi, I'm Garrick and welcome to the Cordless Vacuum Guide. If it's your first time in this channel, please consider subscribing to get notified when I publish new comparison videos like this. For more information about these products, please check the links in the video description below. To start, I'll quickly run through the different options for each model. The Tenneco PureOne S12 has 5 different models: the S12M, M Lite, S12V, S12, and S12 Plus. All these options have the same motor. The difference would be the attachments. For example, the S12M, M Lite, and S12V come with the older direct drive attachment, the same one found in the A11. In comparison, the higher end S12 and S12 Plus have the newer version of the direct drive brush roll, which is larger and better for cleaning long strands of hair. Also, only the S12 and S12 Plus have the LCD screen, while the other three models don't have this feature, but you can use the Tenneco app, which has the same functionality as the LCD screen. The V10, at least in the North American market, has 3 different options: the Absolute, Animal, and Motorhead. The Absolute is a top-of-the-line option that has the fluffy and the torque drive attachment. The Animal version has the same accessories as the Absolute, but minus the soft roller attachment. While the Motorhead is the least expensive option, it has the smaller desktop and older direct drive brush roll that doesn't have the adjustable gates. So the main cleaning head of the V10 Motorhead is similar to the one found in the Dyson V8. Next, we'll look at the similarities, and the first is the design. Both vacuums have interchangeable tools that make them usable as a handheld and stick vacuum. Second, both use a trigger to turn the vacuum on and off. However, only the PureOne S12 has a trigger lock to keep it in the on position, so there's no need to continually squeeze the trigger if you're going over a large space. Lastly, you can replace the battery of these vacuums. The difference is that the PureOne S12's battery does not require any tools to remove, since it has a quick release lever, while the V10 does not. So you'll have to loosen a few screws to remove the battery. Now we'll go through the differences. And while the V10 and S12 had the same motor on top design found in most stick vacuums, the alignment is different. The S12's dust cup is aligned vertically as opposed to the horizontal alignment of the V10. This design gives the V10 the edge when it comes to capacity, as it can hold up to 0.77 liters of dry dirt, same as the V11, while the S12's bin is smaller and can only hold up to 0.6 liters. The difference may not sound a lot, but if you look at the clip, you can see how much more dirt the V10 can hold than the S12. I've also tried to fill it all the way in previous tests, and there wasn't any problem with dirt regurgitating. Another difference is how these vacuums dispose of dirt. The V10 has the hygienic system that pushes dirt down, which minimizes dirt exposure, while the S12 utilizes a trapdoor system that isn't as hygienic. One feature I like with the PureOne S12's design is you can easily remove the filter assembly and wash it without needing special Torx screwdrivers, so this feature makes it easy to give it a thorough cleaning. The Tenneco S12 has an LCD screen that provides information to users about stuff like battery status, potential blockages, and power settings. It also has a slider behind that screen that lets you adjust the airflow. I don't use it as much and leave it at the auto setting and let the iLoop sensor do the work. So it doesn't matter if you're cleaning hard floors or carpet, when the iLoop sensor detects a surge of dirt, the motor will automatically increase suction. The V10 doesn't have this sensor but has 3 fixed settings: low, medium, and high. You adjust the power mode by moving the slide switch up or down. Next, we'll look at the test results, and I'll start with airflow. The PureOne S12 has more airflow across all the power settings. It has as much as 61.72 CFM at the 1 compared to the 59.71 of the D10. The S12 also beats the V10 with more airflow at the main cleaning nozzle, with 50.71 CFM, which is slightly better than the V10's 49.27 CFM. The airflow difference is reflected in the deep cleaning tests, where the PureOne S12 picked up more than the V10. Out of the 100 grams of sand I rubbed on medium pile carpet, it picked up 98.3% versus the 97.03% score of the V10. It also did better on the surface cleaning tests, as you'll see on the table flash on the screen right now. You'll see in this clip that the V10 left a trail of dirt on the forward pass, but it was able to pick it up on the backward and subsequent passes. The PureOne S12 did not have this issue, as it was able to pick up nearly everything in the forward pass. So this is the iLoop sensor at work, as it automatically increases power when it detected an uptick of debris flowing through it. One advantage of this system is there's no need to adjust the power settings as it does it for you, so it's more convenient to use. On hard floors, both vacuums did really well cleaning various types of debris. The soft roller attachment of the V10 and S12 was able to pick up debris of different sizes without any clogging issues, at least for this side-by-side test. I did notice that the S12 soft roller not being able to pick up extra large stuff like roof loops, as it doesn't have as much clearance as the fluffy attachment of the V10. Also, the V10's torque drive attachment did better on the large debris tests using Fruit Loops and Cheerios, as it was able to pick up most of it thanks to the adjustable gates. But you'll have to wiggle the cleaning head to coax the debris to any of the two gates. The S12's lower clearance will be an issue if you're cleaning stuff like this on hard floors. On carpet, both attachments won't have an issue picking up large debris like this. The V10 did slightly better in the sand on hard floor tests, scoring a perfect 100% on two tests using the fluffy and torque drive attachment. However, the torque drive left a trail of sand in the forward pass. The Purun S12 did also well, picking up 99.9% on two tests using the soft roller and the direct drive attachments, with the direct drive attachment picking up most of the sand in the forward pass. Please check the reviews on my blog to see the complete results of the cleaning tests. Both vacuums did well in the hair wrap test, with the S12 doing slightly better. For this experiment, I used 1 gram of 5 to 7 inch human hair and spread it out on hard floors and carpets to see how much hair will wrap around the brush. Hardly any hair wrap on the soft roller and direct drive attachments of the S12. In comparison, there was a small percentage that wrap around the fluffy tool, and a few strands wrap on the torque drive attachment of the V10. So I would give a slight edge to the S12 in this test. In the edge cleaning test, the V10 did better. The soft roller attachment of Dyson was superior to the S12 as it was able to pick up most of the pet litter in the forward pass alone. The torque drive attachment also did a decent job, but it did kick some of the debris backward. Between the two, I'd give the edge to Dyson in this round as the fluffy tool was much better, and the results of the standard brush roll was almost identical, with a slight edge going to Dyson with a fewer debris left behind. The V10 was also better when it comes to steering and moving around furniture. You can see on this overhead shot that the fluffy attachment turns at a much sharper angle than the S12. While the S12 is decent, it has a shallower turning radius. The same goes for the standard brush roll, as the V10's torque drive tool has a more responsive swivel system than the S12's direct drive attachment. Unfortunately, the V10 is noisier, topping out at 76.7 decibels at the max setting, while the S12's loudest is just 70.4 decibels. Between the two, the Purun S12 will run longer, clocking a little over 100 minutes from the two lithium-ion batteries using the crevice tool. With the main cleaning head, expect a runtime of close to 75 minutes, again from the two batteries. The V10 ran for about 61 minutes with the crevice tool at the lowest setting and up to 46 minutes using the torque drive attachment. That number will go down to 27 minutes if you use the middle setting. The Purun S12 has more attachments than the V10, with specialty tools like the flexible crevice tool and the multi-angle adapter, which I really like since it helps a great deal in cleaning areas high above. Make no mistake, the V10 has enough attachments for daily cleaning, but the S12 has much more. So if you're looking for a stick vacuum with better reach, I feel that the S12 is a better option. Lastly, we'll look at the filters. Dyson has a single filter located at the back of the motor. I feel that Dyson's cyclonic system is much more efficient than Tineco's, as you don't need to clean it as often. So this was how dirty the filter was after all the tests I did, and there were a lot. Tineco has two filters, one pre-motor filter located right in the middle of the dustbin, and another post-motor filter at the back. So you'll need to clean the pre-motor filter often, as it kicks up at a much faster rate than Dyson. To wrap up this comparison, the Dyson V10 and Tineco S12 are both very good alternatives, capable of cleaning different areas of your home well. The larger capacity of the V10 makes it ideal for larger homes, as you don't need to empty it as often. It has a better steering system than Tineco, but it doesn't have the trigger lock. The S12's higher airflow make it a better option of the two for those looking for a stick vacuum that can clean carpets thoroughly. It isn't as good as the V11, but it's decent. It also has a much more diverse toolset than any brand I've tested so far. So if you want a vacuum with more attachments, this is the one that I'd get. If you have any questions about these two vacuums, please leave them in the comment section and I'll answer them as soon as possible. For more information about these two products, please check the links in the description. Do like and subscribe if this video is helpful for you. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.